just taken a look at the types and causes of inflation, but let's examine the effects of deflation. Deflation is defined as a sustained decrease in the general price level. A persistently falling price level only occurs if aggregate demand increases at a persistently slower rate than shorter aggregate supply and or longer aggregate supply. This is displayed graphically, where a below full employment equilibrium puts downward pressure on the price level. Referring back to the quantity theory of money, we can see that if money grows slower than the rate of velocity change minus the real GDP growth rate, deflation will occur. The effects of deflation depend on whether or not it is anticipated or unanticipated. Deflation is so rare, though, that it is generally unanticipated. Unanticipated deflation results in a redistribution of income and wealth, lowers the real GDP and unemployment, and diverts resources from production. I'll give a brief explanation of the consequences, but for a more in-depth analysis on these effects, click the card on the top right-hand corner of your screen now, which will redirect you to a previous video I made covering the topic. Workers with long-term wage contracts would experience an increase in real wages, and firms would lose profits because of this. Employers would respond to this by hiring fewer workers, and so unemployment and output fall. With lower output, firms decide to invest less, and this slows the rate of increase of real GDP. Low nominal interest rates increase the quantity of money that people plan to hold, as they would not be getting much interest were they to leave it in a bank account. This decreases the velocity of circulation, and as was mentioned before, this will add to deflation. We've concluded that the cause of deflation is that the quantity of money is growing too slowly. If the central bank were to increase the rate at which money grows in the economy, aggregate demand would be able to better keep up with aggregate supply. Keep in mind, this increase in the money growth rate cannot be a one-time thing. It must be sustained in order to ensure that aggregate demand continues to increase in sync with the long-run and short-run aggregate supply.